Let's open the floor. Any questions for me?
I had the question about the current topic reflection that's due Friday. Is there like a like an instruction or something that goes along with that?
No,
What?
it's a reflection on what we talk about today.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So it's just the same as like our weekly reflections?
Yeah, but we're
Oh,
just
okay.
talking about current topics that are in the world of event management right now.
Oh, okay. I thought it was something different.
Which
Gotcha.
I asked for people's advice on this, and nobody sent me emails with topics that you guys wanted to talk about, so had to pick one. Any other questions? Nobody? Okay. So as I mentioned in the email, today we're because Thursday night is the NFL draft. As I said numerous times in class, event managers are everywhere doing a lot of different things. And first and foremost, here's the with the NFL. There's a group that works within the NFL that actually goes out and sets up all these events. If the draft was occurring as it was scheduled in Las Vegas, there's people from the NFL that go out ahead of time and actually make sure it's true. They do the event for the NFL. But let's talk about how this will work in digital world. So, what do you guys know about the draft on Thursday? Have you read anything? Watched ESPN? Is
Roger Goodell's going to be in his basement recording the whole thing.
that what they said?
That's what I heard.
Oh, look at you with the dig. Look at that background. How about
I want to be more in
that?
class.
How'd you do that?
I did it when I was like coming into the chat. It was like a little setting you could do.
Where's that at? Weird. Ooh, show background effects. Oh boy. Oh boy, hold on. Hold on.
Oh my God.
Hold on. Wow, this is interesting. They just added this. This is all new. You know what? I want to be in my garden. There we go.
Yo.
I'm in my garden. So, that's look at that. That's on the beach. Look at that. We're to California. How about that? We're everywhere. So, Roger Goodell is going to be doing it from his basement and in his boxers. Wow, that could be interesting. What does a $40 million a year person wear for the draft? He'll probably have a suit on top and, business up top. Relax down below. But what else have you seen besides Roger Goodell? How about technology? How's it going to work?
Saw the Bears GM had like 10 monitors set up in his basement with a bunch of cords like running throughout. So I guess a lot of like different data and like player lists and stuff.
You know who's going to do really, who can make a lot of money on this? Your computer geek friends who can go wire stuff up. All those, there's a question. Have any of y'all ever done a live fantasy draft before? Yeah.
Yeah, it gets harder as the rounds, as like you get more into the higher picks. Like you're into it in the beginning, and when it's like the sixth, seventh round, you're just like, whatever, it doesn't really matter. Not everybody's there anymore, or just it's just a lot. It gets worse as it goes on.
Okay, so let's say you guys are all the event staff for the NFL that has to do this. Are the coaches in the NFL very open to change, you think? Do they like, does Bill Belichick like change at all?
Probably not.
No. Every coach I've ever met is a really big creature of habit. They like to know that this occurs at this time of the day, this happens at this time. They're really, really good at doing certain things. And that's how it's supposed to operate. Now, that being said, you want them to change how they've drafted players for 53 years? Where they've met in some ballroom at a, they met at a ballroom at a hotel before and done it. And then they have big parties on like downtown Broadway and Nashville. And now they can't have everybody around because they're worried about, well, how do I do this? How do I make this pick? Who's going to do this? What happens if he's not there? Because they're used to doing it. Anybody see what the Patriots, or not the Patriots, the Saints are doing? It's typical New Orleans fashion. They are have their operations set up in a brewery. Since they can't be in their facility, the ownership of the Saints also owns a brewery in town. So the brewery is not doing anything. So Sean Payton and the GM and all those decide, hey, we're going to set up our operation in the brewery. So they can socially distance, but they have all their computers set up and they're good to go. But from a draft perspective, you're taking something that typically occurs, and the way the draft works is they're in their rooms back in their facilities, their boardrooms or their war rooms, whatever you want to call it, and they make a pick. They then send that pick to their call it in or send it over. Why? Like, this is, it's archaic, but they send it over to the place where the draft is occurring. There's team reps at the draft, the site location, and they'll show the tables with everybody at them. Those people write the name on the card, and then the NFL comes by and picks up the card and takes it in, and they digitally record it, and then the pick's official, and it's in the books. And then Roger Goodell walks out and does his thing. Potentially, it could go by a whole lot faster now, right? Because I immediately enter this in, we hit OK, we verify it, and boom, make your pick. Roger, get up there, talk about it, Mel Kiper tells a spiel, and we move on. But they did a mock draft yesterday with all the teams. And there was an issue already with the first pick. It took 2.5 minutes longer than they were supposed to. So this is something you're trying to think through, because how do I get people patched in? And the NFL, it's got to be a secure feed too, right? Have you guys heard about any security issues with Zoom? Have you heard about those?
Getting hacked and stuff.
Yeah, people hacking into it, which is where stuff like this and Microsoft Teams, it's a little bit safer. I mean, I'm sitting here in front of my little garden, my friends. So you have the opportunity then where people can tap in. And also, I mean, there's some teams in the league that cheat more than others, Patriots. So they could probably be trying to tap in and hack into something, right? So how do I keep my communication secure? How do I set that up? It's great, but from the league perspective, from an event side, what do you think has to be done to make it successful?
There has to be good communication between all 32 teams and Roger Goodell. Unless there's not good communication, then it's just it's not going to go in a fast pace. It's going to drag on for way too long.
Uh-huh.
It's going to cause a lot of problems. But I feel like communication between all of them is the most important thing. That's what they have to really work on for this.
Okay. What else do you need?
Each team should also have a setup plan.
What do you mean?
Like, they should have a set, like, backup. Like, you know how, just basic preparing for the draft. Like, who do you need? Like, what positions do you need? What players do you want to go after for those positions? Have backups for those positions. So, like, everything can go steady and not people are just trying to find someone on a really long list of names.
Okay, well, what about, think from the league perspective, though, right? The league is the one that has to put this on, not the individual teams. You're working for the league to orchestrate this draft occurring in a digital domain as a digital event. So what do you as a league have to have established to make this work? What do I have to have? Oh, Preston disappeared. He got eaten by the surf. What do I have to have to make this class function?
Like a schedule or like guidelines? Is that what you mean? Or like...
No.
No?
No. How are we all able to communicate right now?
Technology.
You gotta have technology. You gotta have some sort of platform where people can partly communicate, but I have to have some sort of infrastructure system that can handle teams submitting picks, that can handle everything that goes into building this draft out that probably didn't exist before, right? To the level that it has to be. Does a software like that currently exist, you think?
I think it does now. Yes, sir. Like, I mean, prior to the, like this whole situation, I don't really think so. But now, like, they've had to make one work.
Okay.
So they've never really been prepared to do, like, a 7-round draft. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And I would be... No, I would probably say I'm 70% confident that the NFL already has a digital system in place that tracks all the picks that occur, right? I would be, if the NFL didn't do it, it was literally some intern at the front of the room typing in an Excel sheet who got picked where, that would be really scary and problematic to me, right? But... if you're the NFL and you need to have a system where, I don't know, the Saints sitting in New Orleans can sit there and type in a player's name, they're going to draft Tua Tagovailoa because he's going to fall in the first round. They're going to type his name in and submit the pick. If you need that software, who could you go talk to get the software from?
Like fantasy sports,
like ESPN. Yeah. I'd be going to ESPN. Oh, what happened there? Whoa, that was weird. I'd be going to ESPN. The NFL even has an NFL fantasy league set up, so they might just go right to their fantasy department and be like, "Hey, let's take the software that we have." And I'm sure, not that I have it in my league this way, but I'm sure that there are settings where if you wanted to, as the commissioner, to approve the picks that come in, right? I'm sure there could be some double-factor authentication that sets up. I mean, all it is a couple guys sitting in a room and just, or a couple programmers sitting there developing the software for it. It doesn't take that long to do. So there can be a system, because that's really what you need. It's that I can send out to all of my 32 teams, say, here's how we're going to run the draft, right? The timer begins. You have this 10-minute window to put your pick in. There's got to be a way where you can make a trade, propose a trade. I don't know if anyone ever done that when you're in your fantasy drafts, but make a trade while in the league, because that's what typically happens. Teams will call each other. How do I get this trade to go through? Can it all be handled in the software? So that's a unique platform that they have to do. And this is all stuff that has to be done in a month, but if you already have a background, so that's your first thing. Second thing is, how do you get, because the NFL is very media conscious, how could you integrate the media into your event?
I think social media has kind of become like a really huge advertising addition. So I think that using social media would be a really good way to get the word out and to advertise.
Okay, so, but I'm talking about media during your event.
Whenever a player gets picked for the draft, I always know, like, when a big player gets picked, the NFL will post on their Instagram just, like, a cool picture of them, like, wearing whatever team uniform. Like, it's, like, a little cartoon picture. But, like, that just, like, that little thing, like, gets your attention, and then you want to go watch the rest of it, I feel like.
Okay, so, I mean, it's going to be on ESPN, so you can watch it. But usually when someone gets drafted, what's one of the first things they do? They come up to the stage, they give the commissioner a hug, right? Usually something along those lines. But then they got to connect an interview. So now I got Mel Kiper Jr. and Trey Wingo sitting in some studio somewhere, right? Or you have the goal, you have basically the Golic and Wingo staff sitting there, probably going to be covering this from Golic's basement. And now I got to get this interview with this person. How do I facilitate all that? That's the question. So you as the NFL have to make sure that something is established so that that can occur.
Before the draft, they should be getting in touch with all the players that, I don't know, you could say go in the first couple drafts, like make sure that they have a good connection and they're able to like do like something like this, like Zoom or like FaceTime or just something face-to-face, and then they have their interviews through that. Mm-hmm. Like they like get in touch with them and plan it. Like, this is how it's going to go. If you get picked, we're going to ask you like two or three questions. That's going to be it.
Okay.
And move on to the next player.
Yeah. If you're the NFL, who's your primary sponsor that you have for all technology stuff? What do they all look at on the sidelines? What's that little blue thing? They come off the field and they hand them the blue thing.
Oh, the tablet.
Microsoft tablets. So who owns or what? You said it, this one for Teams, but what other communication platform does Microsoft own? Do you know?
Look it up.
Do they own Bose?
They don't own Bose. They were the originator of video conferencing. Begins with an S.
Skype.
Oh.
They own Skype. Everyone forgets about Skype now. But what Microsoft did was essentially what we're on right now, Microsoft Teams, is using Skype's technology. And Microsoft put into a different portal, so it has more features and different ways to essentially do content management than just, we'll just do a Skype call. That's what they did. It was about 5 years ago now. They did that with the plan of ultimately creating Teams and trying to get everything integrated in this Office 365 portal. So I don't know if you've watched the news at all, if you've watched CNN. Whenever they have people come on, and by video conference, they always have it, and it says via like Cisco WebEx or whatever. So you could get a sponsor to have Microsoft, could be via Skype, and here's Skype that pops in. So unique way, if I'm the NFL and everything that is done with business that mind, should be done so that can make money off of it. So as a manager, you're trying to monetize what you have. Sponsorships are critical, right? So, I don't know. I challenge you guys to watch the first round of the draft. Or watch the draft appear. There's nothing else on. So watch the draft. And watch it as a event manager and think through, hey, how is this facilitated? How am I making this happen? How can I put all the pieces together? See where event management has taken over the draft at. And that could be your discussion reflection. Put all those pieces together and think through what we've done, everything throughout the semester from, marketing to the other pieces that play into this. How does that work, right? If a player gets drafted, they usually always put on the team hat, right? Well, did the league send every player all 32 hats? Like, how is that happening? Or they send Tua a Dolphins hat? Like, that's the only one he needs? Joe Burrow's wearing a Cincinnati hat? Like, we know that. So, is this how they do this? How do we put it all together? That'd be something that I'd be curious your guys' response from, critiquing the NFL draft from an event manager's perspective. So, but with that, are there any other questions for me? Oh, I am excited about these virtual backgrounds. This is cool. I've been in three places in the meeting. In an office, I was somewhere else, and I was on my Lego farm. So I'm loving this. With that being said, y'all have a good day. Keep after it. If there are any questions, let me know. If you notice, I canceled my office hours in Teams, and I put them on through Zoom. University gave me a Zoom license now. But I don't know, my computer won't allow me to do a virtual background. It's kind of crazy. But that way I can do that. It just makes it easier for people just to come in. If you have questions, hop in there, shoot me an email. Always happy to hop on and talk to you guys, all right? All right. That's all I got.
Thank you.
See y'all later.
See ya.
Yep.